Hey, welcome to the show. I'm Dustin and I'm taking your suggestions on what props you want to see me try to recreate using everyday materials and stuff I can pick up at the hardware store, so let's get started. Alright, so today I'm going to be making the Ooze Canister from Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles 2, The Secret of the Ooze. Now, you want to know what the secret of the ooze is? I'll tell you, it's liquid hand soap. But I'm getting ahead of myself. There's also a clear tube, silver caps on both ends, we've got the logo kind of going across the side of it. So it's kind of a simple build, but I do want to add some lights in. I'm going to put lights in both sides so that the ooze will really glow. I think that'll be pretty cool. Hopefully I can glue it all together and it doesn't leak. But that's basically it, so I'm going to go pick up some parts from the hardware store and then we can get started. All right, so the coolest part about this build is that there's this brand of water that sells these water bottles that are this awesome, amazing tube-like shape. And these are only $1.79 each. For the end caps, I wanted to find some just regular PVC couplings. These are 99 cents each. These are 2-inch and they fit right on this water bottle. So like, how rad is that? That basically is like our whole build right there. I found these cool little magnet clip-on lights. These were $7 a piece that I'm gonna just take apart and hopefully fit those into the end caps so I can make the whole thing glow. I'm gonna fill the whole thing with liquid hand soap. I got this whole giant thing at the 99 cent store. This is gonna be really cool. So shout out to my friend Johnny who did a similar build using these items and gave me the inspiration for this. Okay, so I'm gonna empty these, but I'm not gonna throw this expensive water away. We're in a drought, people. I am gonna use these caps later, so save those. All right, so I think the first thing I'm gonna do is cut these down. They're a little bit on the long side. They sell these half size, so I went with the longer one, and I'm just gonna cut about a third of it off with a saw. All right, these are looking pretty cool. So I'm gonna kind of shave out some of the inside because these are a bit snug, and I wanna make sure that I can really slide these on here. So for that, I'm gonna use my rotary tool and kind of sand it out. You could just go crazy with some sandpaper, probably too. All right, so these are pretty good size. I'm thinking I might pick up one more bottle actually because I don't wanna slide them all the way in. I wanna get that maximum amount of tube and then put two fresh ends all the way into the end of each of those end caps. So I'm gonna pick up one more. I have got my third water. I think this is all the pieces I need. So now I'm gonna start cutting these and putting them together. So I'm gonna take one of my bottles and I'm gonna chop off both ends, leaving as much of the tube as possible. And I'm just using a little hacksaw for that. All right, so that's gonna be the intersection. Before I glue anything into place, I'm gonna take these end fittings. I'm gonna make the holes in the side. There's some oval holes and you can see through into the ooze. Before I cut anything in it though, I wanna make sure I leave room for my light. I found these cool little ones. Look, they just pop right out. They're nice and flat. That's what I was going for. So in the end of this, facing the tube, I'll be fitting this light in here. I need that much space at least. So I'm just gonna cut those holes now. So I'm gonna switch over to the step drill bit. Should go in a lot smoother. Ooh, like butter. To connect the two holes, I'm using my rotary tool and just kind of slicing straight through. And then I just use files and sandpaper to really kind of smooth it out, make them as perfect as I could. All right, those are looking pretty good now. I think I'm gonna go ahead and hit these with spray paint. All right, so I'm just gonna go with the metallic paint. These are usually around $4. Okay, paint is dry, so the next thing I'm gonna do is go ahead and attach these directly to the tube. So I am using hot glue for this, just to make this process a little faster. I hope it's gonna be watertight and this won't leak all over the place, but if you wanna get really fancy with it, you should probably use marine silicone. That is totally waterproof and it takes a while to set, but it'll last for a long time and won't leak. So that is nice and solid. So here's what I'm gonna do with the extra two bottles. I'm using just the ends of them and I'm gonna cut them and fit them right into the end, and I'm leaving just enough space in the very end to put our LED. I'm having a hard time fitting these in, so I'm just shaving it out a little bit more with the rotary tool and just really smoothing out the inside some more, and so now they fit in just fine. All right, so before I glue these end pieces in place, I'm gonna drill a hole in just one of them because that's how we're gonna fill it with liquid in a little bit. I hope this doesn't leak. This is gonna leak. Mine is definitely gonna leak. All right, so for the lettering on the side of the canister where it says TGRI, not TCRI like the comics, we're doing the movie version, so it's a G. I had this printed out on some transparency. I just typed this out on the computer. I found a font that kind of looked close enough. So here's a trick that I use when I'm printing on transparency is go ahead and print it mirror image. So it's backwards. When you flip it over, the color really pops for some reason when you do that. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna spray paint the backside of this so that's totally silver. Cut that out and I'll glue it right to the side of the canister. All right, so I just tested out a bunch of different types of glue. Since the spray paint is on the bottom side, it reacts with different glue different ways. So be careful, you might not wanna use glue at all. So I'm gonna scratch the glue entirely. I'm gonna put clear packing tape across the top and leave a little bit of a border on the top and bottom, and that will hold it into place, no glue. That is not bad. Can't even tell that there's tape. All right, so the last thing I'm gonna do is just cut these caps down a little bit so they will fit and be our actual end caps. To fit this light inside here, I'm just gonna shave down a little bit of the side so it fits right in. One last thing I did do, it's not totally movie accurate, but I added little screws to the end, just as little handles, so that way later we could like actually pull it off and access our lights. But this should be pretty good with fitting our lights in there. Okay, I think it's time to fill it with ooze. Well, I made a quick funnel out of my leftover transparency so I'd have a little easier time pouring the ooze in. All right, here we go. The ooze. Oh shoot. Okay, it is fully leaking out of my holes right here. I'm gonna have to empty this and maybe re-hot glue it. I told you this was gonna leak. I mean, the good news about making a mess with soap is that it's soap. I'm trying to fill any spots that I think are leaking with a bunch of different types of glue. All right, so it is now after 10 p.m. and I cannot get this thing to hold water. I was hoping that the hot glue might be a good temporary solution to hold the ooze in place, but it's starting to look really bad. So I'm gonna attempt to rip the ends completely off and put it back together. So I'll be using some sort of waterproof silicone on this, and then we'll pick back up from there. All right, so it's been a few days. I totally rebuilt this thing. I was able to salvage these end caps, sanded it down, made it nice and fresh, and repainted them, and then got three new water bottles. And the most important thing is that I used the silicone, so definitely use that. Do not use the hot glue. This is just clear silicone. It's waterproof, but it has to sit for 24 hours. So that's what I've done. So let's attempt to put in the ooze one more time. I did test this with water, which is a good idea. I should have done that before just to see if there's any leaks. If it leaks this time, I swear. No leaks. No leaks. So, we have to plug the hole that's in the end that we just put the ooze in. I found one of these little electrical twisty cap things. So I'm just gonna use that and really shove it in here because it feels pretty snug. Go ahead and use the silicone around there. And then what you can do too, if you wanna make an extra cap, just find an old piece of plastic, like this is just leftover packaging. I'm gonna cut a circle out of this and then you can just silicone all the way around the edge, make a nice seal, and then let it dry for a good 24 hours. One LED. Just gonna turn it on. Oh yeah. Just put the cap on top of it. Fits right into place. And you can always access these, turn them off, change batteries. That is official ooze. I figured out the secret of the ooze, and it was don't use hot glue, use silicone. Okay, that is my DIY glowing ooze canister. Turned out pretty rad. Had a few mishaps, but we figured it out. So I spent about $20 on the whole thing, and that doesn't include the little bit of spray paint I used. And even with the rebuild, I only spent another $5. So that's not really that bad. So let me know in the comments if you have any other questions and what other props you want to see me build. And if you do any of these builds yourself, I would totally love to see them. So be sure and tag them DIY Prop Shop. And check out the Ami Gear Shop because we have this t-shirt available for you to buy. And be sure and subscribe to the channel to see what I'm going to build next. All right, see you guys next time. Ooze.